Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the second session of Java and Web, Variables, Data Types and Operators. In this video, we will discuss what is an identifier in Java. We already done with some simple programs in the Java. This is the time to make ourselves friendly with various other terms related to a Java program. First among them is the identifier. An identifier can be name of a variable, can be name of a method, a class, an interface, etc. decided by the programmer. If you remember, we were deciding the name of the class, we were deciding the name of the variables. So the names which are decided by the programmer are called identifiers. Any name decided by the programmer is an identifier. Look at this program. We already done with this type of programs. All red color words are names decided by programmers. This word add, this word main, args, A, B, C, D. These all red color words are decided by programmers. Hence, they are identifiers. A, B, C and D are names of variables. Add is the name of the class. Main is the name of function. And args is name of the array. All of these are identifiers. All these names are decided by us as a programmer. Name of the function depends on the programmer. But for execution of JVM, we need a function whose name is main. Means at least one function should be present in our class whose name is main. Although the name decided by the programmer, but there must be a function whose name is main main. And in between these small brackets, it contains the same thing which is written here. For now, a function with name main is compulsory. Later we will use functions with different names. If something is decided by the programmers, there must be some rules for such decisions. There are following rules of writing identifiers. Allowed characters in a Java identifier are capital A to Z, small a to Z, digits 0 to 9, underscore and dollar. You cannot use any character other than what are written here. Although digits are the part of identifier, but identifier cannot start with a digit. Examples of some valid identifiers are hello underscore all, capital H E L L O underscore all. This one is also a valid identifier because it is following all the rules of identifiers. A is an identifier, underscore apple 12 is also a valid identifier. There are some examples of invalid identifiers like this one, one hello underscore all. Since this word is starting with a digit, that's why this identifier is an invalid identifier. Hello underscore all has. The word hello underscore all has using an invalid character has. Has is not allowed in the identifier. As you can see, only these characters are allowed. Now let's check some valid and invalid identifiers with example. I already created a program. First, 1.java. You can see here the line I am commenting out are invalid identifiers. These two are invalid identifiers. This one is perfectly valid. This one is perfectly valid. This one is also perfectly valid because it is not starting with a digit and also not use any special character other than underscore and dollar. So all these three are valid identifiers. If I print all those valid identifiers, they will print 2, 4 and 6. Let me execute this program. Java C, first 1.java. Compiler executes fine, then type Java first. Because class name was first, so I have to write first here. Here class name and file name are different. Class name is the first, but file name is first1.java. After writing Java space first, press enter. And it executes. Says hello underscore all is equal to 2, hello 2 all is equal to 4, underscore dollar is equal to 6. So all these identifiers are perfectly valid. Now let me uncomment some invalid identifier and check what the compiler throws as an error. Let me check if I remove comment line from the hello has all, then it says illegal character has. You can see we cannot use has in any identifier, and this error is thrown by Java compiler, not the JVM, not the Java. So this error is thrown by Java C, the Java compiler. This is called compilation error, compile time error. Now let me again comment out this line and uncomment this line, which contains two hello all. Since this identifier starts with the digit, the compiler also should throw error in this case. Let me compile it again. Java C first1.java. It says this is not an statement and wants a semicolon after int. Identifiers are case sensitive, means the same word with different alphabetical case are considered as a different identifier. Here hello, the first hello with a small h, is a different identifier than a hello with the capital H. So these two are different identifiers. So these two are different variables. Let me execute this program also. Vi first2.java. You can see we have a hello word starting with capital H and another hello word starting with small h. Compile it. Java C first2.java. Compiles fine and run it. Java first. Again, file name is first2, but class name is the first. It executes fine. Here both identifiers are same words with same alphabetical case. So they are same identifiers. We cannot have more than one identifier in the same block, even if their types are different. Since the word is the same, alphabetical cases are same, so both identifiers are also same. And these two identifiers are under the same block. The opening and closing curly bracket is called a single block. So our two same identifiers are in same block. This is an error. We cannot have same identifiers in the same block. We cannot have two variables in the same scope with the same name. The one block is called one scope in the Java. So we cannot have two variables in the same scope with same name. The compiler will produce an error in such a case. Let me go in program first2, vi first2.java and change the name to a small h. Now both identifiers are same because they are same word with the same alphabetical case. Let me compile this one. Java C first2.java. It says variable hello is already defined in the method main and we are again defining it. So this is a compilation error if you have same identifier in the same scope. One more thing I want to discuss in this video is there are some special statements. Means you know that a line ending with semicolon is a statement. The only semicolon is also a valid statement. This one is a valid statement. If I run this program, let me delete this, otherwise it will produce an error. Only semicolon is a valid statement. If I run this program, Java C first2.java, everything is fine. Java first. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.